Raphael Levy for tcgplayer.com. This is round one of a league, standard league. We're playing Mono Black. And we are on the play, and this is a keeper. So on an empty board, on the play, we open with Knight Market Lookout. On the draw, we'd probably open with a Dread Wanderer, just in case they have a blocker. And we can trade, like for example, a 2-2 blocker Servant, for example. We would play the Wanderer on turn one. But the Night Market Lookout will pretty much give us an extra life. Okay, we have a Bone Picker here. We just drew a Bone Picker. Attack for two. We can play a Ballista for zero and play Bone Picker, but I think I just play a Dread Wanderer here. This deck is not actually very good against energy decks. If it's a Teemer Energy or a like Marvels or a Tower, Teemer Tower. It's not great, but this one has black, so it might be a black-red energy. It's probably a lot better. All right, so here we have Grasp of Darkness. So we're gonna grasp the blocker, play a Bone Picker, because a creature died this turn. And we have another removal and a Walking Ballista. This is pretty much the best draw you can have. It's very close to the best draw you can have. If you replace the Dread Wanderer by a Siphoner, I don't exactly know how to pronounce it. I'll just say Siphoner for the rest of the recording so it makes sense. Alright, so he killed the Wanderer, and now we have the choice. We can either kill it right now and attack for 5, or hold it back and give him another mana for next turn. I think we just kill it here. Hold him off the 4 and 5 mana. And this is also an extra damage next turn, or an extra damage if I need. I can just attack and ping him for 1 and drain him for 1 before he blocks. He has to take care of the flyer and play a blocker for the lookout. 3 mana, Rogue Refiner, it's fine. This is Sultai Energy. Fatal Push. Let's see, what do we do here? I think we play the Scrounger and attack with Bone Picker. Yeah, I don't care so much about the Rogue Refiner here. So next turn, if he has nothing, I think I have lethal. I can play Ballista. Let's see if it was next turn, if it was on 6. I can play Ballista for 1. Fatal Push the Rogue Refiner. Ping him for 1. Have access to 9 damage this next turn. If he has no other blocker. And if he has one more blocker, I think it's still fine. Still works the same. Well, actually, that's exactly what we're discussing. Yeah, okay. Well, he might have a Fatal Push, but if he doesn't, then he's exactly dead. Is that right? Yeah, he's exactly dead. It's a very good example. Oh, we could actually do that instead. but then we can't play the then we can't play Fatal Push, but that's okay, we can still kill it with it. So if he has a Fatal Push and he kills my Bone Picker. Actually, he can't. He can only kill the Scrounger, which would be okay. So what's better here? Play the Ballista or the Brutality? If he kills our Bone Picker, we lose the Ballista and Fatal Push. If we just do this for two, we lose the. We can also drain him for two. So we drain for two, we duress kinda and kill it. If he kills the Bone Picker, he takes 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And I lose my Ballista. And he goes down to two. Or if I play Ballista, shoot the Refiner, attack, he kills the Bone Picker, he takes 3, 4, and we still have the Brutality in hand. That's about the same thing, except that if I've except what yeah, I think I'm gonna do this, the three modes, tight opponent, this and tight opponent. If you have zero card for the Dread Wanderer next turn. We still have lethal. Filled with a scrap. Okay, so he did have it. But at least we keep the flyer. Liliana is fine, doesn't do anything. So the only good thing about this was that we kept the Bone Picker. Combat, okay. The other way around, we would have lost the Bone Picker off the Fatal Push, and that's a good reason to play like this. Never, he has a Liliana. Liliana does not do much here. He can bring back this guy, but he's still losing to a flyer. He can gain 3 life, go up to 5, but I still have lethal in play. Probably using the vessel. I don't know what saves him here. Maybe Virtuoso. I don't think he plays Virtuoso in his Sultai energy. Actually, the blue might be for. What is the blue for? Could be for Gearhulk. So, let's see. I played this deck a little bit and it feels like. The Delirium decks, like you should board in Scarab Feast against Delirium decks. Against this one, it's energy, so it's not as much Delirium as the, well, as like Green Black Delirium. I think we bring in the Transgress the Mines. Not sure about Fatal Push. I think we can at least take one out. What's not great against them? It's pretty hard to sideboard against sideboard just with this deck. What did we kill with this? We killed quite a few creatures, so not taking out too many cards. I think it would be too many discard spells. We still want to be active, so I think that should be good. I don't like having too many discards, especially since this one does not hit. Ishkana or Liliana are cards that you really want to take to get rid of. So I think I'm gonna stay that way. All right, that hand is not as good since we don't have any. Early pressure. We have a transgress, we have removal. This is not a great hand. I might. I consider mulligan. On the play, I would probably have mulliganed. Well, I'm gonna keep. Hopefully, I'll do some pressure. He mulliganed on the play. That makes our keep a little better. Since we can't get rid of a threat, an extra card. Ballista, not the best early threat. Servant? Yeah. Alright, so I'm gonna. That's probably the best. The best setup for us. So now we can actually play our threat. So we have the fatal push on our turn. We didn't do it on the end of turn. So we can play a 3-2 flyer. And next turn we have never or transgress the mind, depending on what he plays. Another servant, okay. It's likely he has a fatal push, and I don't think I want to run into it. I think I want to play Transgress the Mind first and see what he has. Or maybe attack first. Yeah, I'll attack first. And if he doesn't have it, then I'll probably kill the servant next turn. It's kind of double fatal push. So that play was actually pretty good. Alright, so we play land and pass. So we're definitely not killing the servant. He can actually kill his own servant and kill the bone picker, which would be pretty bad for him. We'd lose three cards to take care of the 3-2 flyer. Alright, play a land and attack for three. So here, what do we want to do? Do we want to play the Ballista or the Lookout? The Ballista will call for Fatal Push. Is there a better spot I can play it? Yeah, I think I'll just play it. All right. Yeah, take two. Trading the fatal push for one card and two damage. Remove. Can actually kill the servant, but I think I'm just gonna ping him twice. It also speeds up the clock. Now it's only 4 turns. Used to be 3, so it used to be 5. Rogue Refiner, that's okay. Now we can actually kill the servant. Unless he doesn't want to. He doesn't want to attack. In case I kill one of his guys. No, he's still attacking. All right, I'm taking. Now I'm killing the servant. Scrounger. So I'm attacking for three. Killing the servant. Playing the lookout. And passing the turn. So now he's 3 turns or less if he oh yeah, well, 4 now. Yeah, I didn't want him to have 4 mana for the for marvels if he plays marvels. I'm not sure he does, but he could be. I mean, the puzzle knots have to be there for something. So now he doesn't have a fatal push in hand. And he doesn't have a delirium either. So I think now that we have mana, we're just gonna play this guy. Kill the refiner so he doesn't have a blocker. And attack with the bird. And now we have two more zombies ready to crawl back to life. Another land. Yeah, the bird is doing a lot of damage here. All right. We even have the land to do everything we want here. To bring the scrounger back and make a dude. And taking care of the fatal push. So it's one less instant. And he's on six. Oh, he has another one. Oh. Well, we didn't quite have the choice here. We had to attack. Okay. Bring back the scrounger. Yeah, take the lookout. I want to keep the ballista in the graveyard in case I have a Liliana. Dread Wanderer, that's pretty good too. Beginning of combat, okay, attack. Question is, do I play my return now? Well, I guess we are. The worst thing would be like a wrath effect, like the Hades expertise, but doesn't look like he has some, like he has that, because he would have gained life instead. So I think I'm just gonna go all in, just in case oh, it's too many fatal push now. Just in case he has what's his name? Ulamog. All right, and the round one, us.